Hi everybody, my new book about songwriting, Try This At Home, is out imminently. It's a book, the subtitle is Adventures in Songwriting. It's me talking about the things I know and think about songwriting after 2 decades in the game. And continuing with this series, I want to talk about the song The Road. The Road is a song, it's kind of the closest thing that I would confess to being a folk punk song, folk punk, in my catalogue. It was written in large part when I was on tour with Chuck Reagan and Tim Barry as part of the Revival Tour in the USA in 2008, and then released in 2009 on the album Poetry of the Deed. It uses basic sort of country and folk chords, and then it has a more full band arrangement. So we'll talk through the way the song is put together musically, and we'll talk about the lyrics a bit as well. The basis of it, so we're in A minor, there's an A minor chord there, and there's some pretty standard country licking going on at the start, so you go. Like that, you got that. So you're keeping the top half of your hand where it is, isn't it? Like that, so you just kind of vamp is the technical term, so you go. And then basically it uses a pretty standard set of chords, so the chorus goes, to the east, with the road beneath my feet. And that's a G, and then an E over G sharp, which is the 4th fret on the bottom string, then back to the A again. It does that twice, and then it goes, to the north, never to be caught. To the south, my time is running out. So you got A, C, G. E over G sharp, A is the first half, and then the second half goes C, G, F, C, and then F, C, G, E over G sharp, A, like that. So that's so there's 2 halves there. And I start with the most basic traveling image I can think of. I wanted to write a song about the road. I felt like about touring. I started with the compass road, so it kind of works through the different directions of the compass. Then we get to the verses. The verses, it's quite a long chord sequence, but it's all basic chords. So you just go A minor, E minor, F, G, C, G, F, and then a D major, which is the second chord of the C scale. So it's a sort of major second chord, which is a very country thing to do. A lot of George Jones songs, Merle Haggard, people like that will use a major second. So you go. And those are your 2 chord sequences for the song, because the middle 8 is actually the same chords as the chorus, but with a sort of half-time traditional hardcore beat down, I suppose would be the word, drum beat. But the Ben's electric guitar part plays a higher thing up the top, so and it's high dyads. A dyad is a chord with 2 notes in it. So you're on the 7th fret of the D string and the 8th fret of the high string, with the ones in between blocked with the middle bit of your finger. So you go, and then. So you've got down to 2 and 3, and then 3 and 5, and then skipping towards the ceiling of string, as it were, you go, so you've got 2nd fret on the A string, 3rd fret on the D string, and then. So it's the same chords, but it's kind of an inverted version thereof. And the only other bit musically is the very outro bit, which I sometimes play live and sometimes don't, depending on whether or not the momentum of the set requires it, is the last 4 chords of the chorus, which, as you'll remember, are F, C, G, E over, over G sharp, A minor, and it's played up at the top with some 6th notes in. So if you play an F chord up here, but then keep that 10th fret on the top E string as well, so go, and then to a C, and then the same shape on a G, and then on the record it actually goes up to a high A minor, which is hard to play with a guitar that doesn't have a cutaway, which is why sometimes I'll play it there instead, which is A string and then 10, 9, 10. So, and it's the same rhythm as the middle 8, so it sort of brings the song together. That's the music for the song. And then the lyrics, you know, it's just a discussion of touring and how I feel about touring. There's a little reference to Lord of the Rings in there, keep it secret, keep it safe. And sort of going around stories about being on the road, meeting strange people. One little trick in it, there's a lyric in the song where it says, punk's an old DC, which is a bit clunky because old DC isn't really a thing. That, of course, comes down to the fact that I knew when I wrote the song that Tennessee would scan much better, but I hadn't actually ever been to Tennessee when I wrote the song. I put in old DC instead, and then literally months later, played a show in Tennessee. But I'm a stickler for accuracy, what can I say? Anyway, that's the song and the whole thing on acoustic guitar goes something like this. To the east, with the road beneath my feet. To the west, but I haven't got there yet. And to the north, never to be caught. To the south, and my time is running out. Ever since my childhood, I've been scared, I've been afraid. Trapped by circumstances, staying in one place. So I always keep a small bag full of colognes carefully stored. Somewhere secret, somewhere safe, somewhere close to the door. Well, I've traveled many countries, washed my feet in many seas. I'm drunk with grifters in Vienna and with punks in old DC. And I've driven across deserts, driven by the irony that only being shackled to the road could ever I be free. To the east, with the road beneath my feet. To the west, well I haven't got there yet. And to the north, never to be caught. To the south, and my time is running out. I felt old before my time, but now I'll keep the age away. By burning up the miles, and yeah, by filling up my days. And the nights, 2,000 nights I play, 1,000 more to go. Before I take a breath and steal myself for the next 2,000 shows. To the east, the road beneath my feet. To the west, well I haven't got there yet. And to the north, never to be caught. To the south, and my time is running out. Adventures in Songwriting is out later this week. Hope you enjoy. Take it easy.